To another new Sunday here at Sunshine Salvos here in this online service. Welcome to you. It's great that you could join us here on this new day, in this new month, in this new season. Can you believe we're now officially into the season of autumn here in Australia? I've heard that this particular autumn season is going to be a hot one. And I think that that is probably just another symptom of climate change and many of the things that I know that meteorologists are talking about in the way that our planet, and particularly as we feel it here in Australia, just seems to be heating up at this time. Of course, that still means that there will be certainly dangerous periods for many, particularly in country Australia. I think particularly of those here in the state of Victoria, where I'm located, who certainly have been under threat of bushfires in recent days and weeks, and that looks like that will be a continuing reality in and through this first month of autumn, this hot month. This really is and does feel like an extension of summer. But here we are on this new day, celebrating life, celebrating our journey, celebrating the God whom we worship. And we do so today looking at a very interesting painting, and already you will have got a very distinct feel for what we are going to be contemplating today. We will be looking at an Aboriginal art print by Aunty Glendora Naden. this wonderful print entitled So Loved. And it is sourced in that most famous Bible verse within the Gospel of John, chapter 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world. Encapsulated in Dreamtime art in this magnificent picture, which we will have a look at in due course through this online service. You will have picked up, of course, that there will be a particular First Nations emphasis in our online service today, as appropriately respectful in accordance with the wonderful art that we're looking at today as an Indigenous Australian artwork. But welcome to you. I hope you've had a great week. It's always good to see you and know that you continue to support us at Sunshine Salvos through your continuing presence here in this online space. My prayer is that you will certainly have a sense of God drawing you nearer and dearer unto Himself through how we worship Him this day, and particularly through what He imparts to us through particularly the artwork that we are going to consider in just a little while from now. It's been a busy week for us at Sunshine Salvos. Here I am saying that again. We had a really lovely prayer service just a couple of days ago on Friday, the 1st of March, the first Friday in the month of March, which is always the day for the World Day of Prayer service. And that was hosted this year by Sunshine Salvos. It was a lovely occasion where we had 20 friends from across a number of churches in our local community come together in an ecumenical service that prayed for and focused on that war-ravaged state of Palestine. It's a particularly inspired and poignant choice this year for the prayer focus. How appropriate, how pertinent that we would pray for Palestine at this time for those people in that war-torn state who need our prayers so desperately at this time. It was a lovely occasion to come together and pray and center our thoughts and our prayers and our energy towards praying for Palestine. But of course, life goes on, and here we are, here again on Sunday. The weeks just seem to click over quicker and quicker as we're getting into this year. We come this day and we worship on traditional lands. I want to invite a First Nations person, Tahana Turner, who's going to come and she's going to acknowledge First Nations leaders, traditional custodians, and welcome us to country and to this online service today, appropriately remembering and recognising the traditional custodians of this great Southland. I throw it over to you, Tahana, to introduce us to this worship service in the right way on this day, acknowledging the traditional custodians of the lands where we're gathered today.
Jingiwala Jimbalans, hello friends. Wherever you are in this great country, let us all honour and praise Nathangali, our Creator God who formed this incredible land. As we gather today on different countries, we acknowledge the traditional custodians whom Creator God has entrusted custodianship over these amazing countries. We respect the enduring connection the traditional custodians have with creation and with the Creator. Everything we touch and everything we see, we appreciate their care and connection to this land. We remember our ancestors of the past and our elders who are present with us. Their stories and knowledge will be passed on for the generations that are to come. Remember that wherever you are standing today, you are standing on sacred ground.
And I add to that, as I always do, the commitment of the Salvation Army Australia Territory to the process of reconciliation, walking alongside First Nations people ensuring that we do our level best to achieve justice for them and to provide a voice for them wherever and whenever necessary. We gather on lands this day here in Australia that were never ceded. They were, they are, they always will remain Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander lands. Now, you might have noticed that I'm wearing a t-shirt today that you wouldn't have seen before. This is a very new t-shirt. It comes from the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander team of the Salvation Army. It's a fantastic print. It reflects the heart of our First Nations team within the Salvation Army that draws upon that wonderful foundational inspirational verse from the prophet Micah, chapter 6, verse 8, that talks about acting justly, loving mercy, and walking humbly with our God. And although you can't see it, on the back of this shirt there is a wonderful First Nations image and piece of art in its own right. I'm not going to turn around and show you that because I want us to focus on this particular piece of Aboriginal art today. But just so that you know that I am wearing this brand new Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander t-shirt endorsed by the Salvation Army's Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander team. We begin with a prayer. This particular prayer comes from a very well-known source, Martin Luther King Jr. And this prayer really reminds us of discipleship, the journey, and what it means to come to the cross to follow Jesus. Would you join with me as we begin our worship time this day in prayer? Come, Lord Jesus, come, and teach us again that to be your disciples, we must take up our cross with all of its difficulties and agonizing and tragedy-packed content. And we must carry it until that very cross we carry leaves its marks upon us and redeems us to that more excellent way, which comes only through suffering. Give us wisdom and patience and strength to understand the meaning of following you, Jesus, through that prayer. We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to sing a worship song this morning, a hymn of the church. It fits in well with the theme of today, talking about the love of God. So wonderful, so self-explanatory, so embedded within our faith through that simple verse that we're going to contemplate today through this piece of art, John 3:16. God so loved the world that he gave his only son. That love is what we sing of today, the love of God, the kind of love that gives of itself unconditionally in the most amazing, gracious, and forgiving way possible. Would you join with me as we sing this hymn this morning, The Love of God?
Apart from his sin.
Affirmation of our faith, that gift to us that is God's love, we move from that to a time of prayer, knowing that our God of love sits on the throne of heaven, receiving our prayers and answering them all. In faith we pray, knowing that He answers prayer. Would you join with me this day as we pray? Amen. Some announcements I have for this new month of March. And I don't have my newsletter here, so I'm going to have to try and go by my memory of what is contained within the new newsletter, which is up on our Sunshine Salvos Facebook group page. If you haven't seen it already, get online, have a look at our Sunshine Salvos Facebook page. You'll find our newsletter for the month of March there. It contains all of what's going on in this particular month. And it's a pretty jam-packed month because this month moves, of course, into the Lenten season, which we find ourselves in as we speak. Takes us to the cross of Christ and to that glorious resurrection day of joy at the end of this month of March. But before then, let me remind you that Shine Ladies, next Saturday, you have a fantastic lunch coming up on Saturday the 9th of March, 12 o'clock midday at Sunshine Salvos, 42 Devonshire Road, Sunshine. Come along, ladies, and you will be celebrating the International Day of Women, celebrating your womanhood, celebrating all things of your sisterhood, celebrating all the best things about your femininity, all the things that Shine love to just cast a light on. And it's going to be a great day for you, Shine ladies. Major Patsy Shadbolt is going to be bringing to you a wonderful message that reflects on International Women's Day and the power of womanhood and what that means. And she'll also share a bit of her story as well. It's an interesting story of Patsy's life. That's this coming Saturday, ladies, 12 o'clock midday at Sunshine Salvos. Other announcements include that next week after, there will be a period of most of the week from the 11th of March through to the 14th and 15th of March. Our Sunshine Salvos Centre will be closed in that time as Captain Fung and myself attend an officers fellowship conference that will take us away for that whole week, so that all of our normal activities that take place through that week on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday will go into recess just for that week. We'll be back on the Friday for the community meal. Very little stops that, but just to let you know that our centre will be closed in that week starting the 11th of March. Other announcements coming up include, of course, Easter. We move into the period of drawing towards Jerusalem, drawing towards the cross. Good Friday service will take place at 9:30 a.m. on Friday the 29th of March. And of course, that will then culminate over that holy weekend into Easter Sunday on the 31st, our normal church service on that day, that glorious day, Resurrection Sunday. Of course, the online services go through all of those days as normal, but there will certainly be a lot of things going on at Sunshine Salvos that help us prepare for that Passion Week at the end of March. There are other announcements contained within the newsletter. I think I will leave the announcements there. As I said, download it, consult it on our Facebook group page. Everything is there, including our prayer list for people to pray for during the month of March. And I encourage you to do that because we all need prayers. We all need to support each other, love each other, and lift each other up in prayer whenever possible. That's the announcements I leave with you for today. Any particular Sunday where we focus particularly on First Nations people here in Australia, Australian Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples, inevitably we will always come back to that wonderful contemporary anthem by Jeff Bullock, The Great Southland. Particularly so since he revised his lyrics, and I know I've spoken about this here in this forum a number of times. He revised his lyrics to more appropriately respect our First Nations people and honour them through revised lyrics in the first and second verses particularly. We're going to sing again, of course, of that great south land of the Holy Spirit, a land of red dust plains and summer rains, a land that is drenched in the goodness of God, and who through the ages, through our Aboriginal communities, the oldest living civilizations in the world, our Indigenous Australian First Nations people, God's goodness and grace has been shown through them, through their lives, through their dreaming, through their spirituality. And we're going to sing of it, and we're going to celebrate and worship the God of the dream time together here today, the great Southland.
This is your nation, this is your land, this common future, this shared hope, land of reaping, this land of harvest, this is your land, this is our home, this is a great south land of the Holy Spirit. Land of red dust plains and summer rains, and in this sunburnt land we have seen His love. To this great south land His spirits come. This is your nation, this is your land, this land of plenty, this land of hope, the richest harvest is in her people. From age to age, His spirits come. This is a great south land of the Holy Spirit. Land of red dust plains and summer. Great Southland, your spirits come. Whoa, 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 whoa. This is your nation, this is your land, this lucky country of dreams gone dry. And to all people, there is a heart. And to this land His spirit comes. This is a great south land of the Holy Spirit. Land of red dust plains and summer rains. And in this sunburnt land we have seen His love. To this great south land His spirits come. This is a great south land of His Holy Spirit. Land of red dust plains and summer rains. And in the sunburned land we have seen His love. To this great south land His spirit comes. To this great south land His spirit comes. To this great south. Spirit comes. Whoa, 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 whoa.
A Bible reading. It's only one verse, so I'm going to make it quick. And to be honest, I don't even need to look at the Bible to read this one, because this is the one verse in the Bible which we all should know. We all learn it if we've grown up in Sunday school. And even those who haven't been in Sunday school will often know this one verse from the Bible. Of course, it comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 3, verse 16. It's the inspiration behind Aunty Glenny Naden's beautiful Aboriginal print here, so loved. Let me just remind you of that iconic verse from the Gospel of John. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, so that whosoever would believe in him would never perish, but would have eternal life. And that is the heart behind this Dreamtime spiritual offering in art that we consider today by Aunty Glenny Naden. So loved. I'm going to give you a moment just to reflect upon this wonderful Aboriginal art print. Absorb it, take it in. Note particularly the focus points on this art, the different objects and shapes around them. And after we've just considered this artwork, we're going to come back and we will look in at Aunty Glenny's own words as to how she describes this piece of art and how it reflects her faith, particularly from the Bible verse that we just read. Aunty Glenny Naden's wonderful offering that we contemplate this day. So loved. So I'm not an expert in Aboriginal art. I don't profess to be. I think we know from Aboriginal art in general that certainly the technique of using dots is a very common technique. And certainly we see within this artwork that very present array, beautiful system of flowing dots in the way that this artwork takes its form and shape. But of course we see within this artwork the centrality of the cross. Of course that cross comes at the very center of John 3:16, that God through his love would give his only Son, ultimately reflected in and through Jesus's salvific act on the cross. But we see these other elements of the painting that really are striking, and also most striking is just the colour itself. You know, when we were singing just before the Great South Land of the Holy Spirit, we reflected on red dust plains. When I look at this artwork, I see red dust plains. The ochre colours of this particular piece of art are quite striking, and beautifully so. But let's hear from Aunty Glenny herself, who says this about this artwork she did. And I guess to also mention that this particular artwork was painted around 4 or 5 years ago. It's interesting that we looked at a piece of art last week that was only 4 years ago. This is also from a very similar time frame. And so Aunty Glenny and a number of other First Nations artists were given a commission to put together a book of Aboriginal Christian art from a book called Our Mob, God's Story. And this is one of the focal pieces from that book, Our Mob, God's Story. So loved, taking its place, of course, as a prominent piece of art within that series. This is what Aunty Glenny Naden says of her artwork here. So loved. She says, the painting is based on the verse of John 3:16. That was a favourite verse of mine from Sunday school days on the mission where I grew up. God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son to die that we might have life. The groups on the sides of the painting, and when I say the groups, I'm referring to all of these little U-shaped groupings around the side. These shapes representing continents and lands and different peoples from different lands around them on each side. Different colours, different cultures, different peoples. The groups on the side of the painting represent the people of the world, showing all their different cultures and countries and colours. And at the top of the painting is a heavenly realm where God is, and what is the much anticipated place for all believers. And that's all Aunty Glenny really says about her magnificent art print here. She kept it fairly brief. I should probably do the same. What I see in this heavenly realm, of course, are three prominent focal points of shape that I believe may well represent the Trinity God that we worship, Father, Son, and Spirit. Of course, central to this print, as I mentioned before, is the cross of Christ, that place of ultimate love, sacrificial love, demonstrated through Christ's obedience unto death so that we might have life. And as Aunty Glenny said, we have all different people from different nations on the sides represented in their belief, in their journey of following Jesus and living in accordance with his will and his salvation. And we also have these streams that seem to almost be flowing down, with this cross almost appearing to be on like a hill. And that's consistent, of course, with the biblical account of Golgotha being a hill or a raised, elevated mark of land. And these almost looks like streams of water flowing down. But we also have these tracks that go up to the cross. All of these different particular avenues that all lead to the cross. And these ones that come up from above as well, that lead back to the centrality, the foot of the cross. And I look at these particular tracks that lead up to the cross, tracks where many would come to the cross, as we will certainly at the end of this month when we come again to consider the sacrifice of Jesus and what that means for us in our faith, when we get to Good Friday and certainly Easter Sunday. We all return to the cross, but we have all these tracks where people can journey to the cross. And it brings me back, of course, to the Bible verse, which is at the very heart of this really wonderful Aboriginal print. The heart of it that reflects upon the centrality of this cross and Jesus dying for all of creation, that all of creation would be liberated to live again, to be able to be saved and to come under the salvation and grace of God. And many people journey to that place of grace at the foot of the cross. And the journey is not always the same journey. There is not one track here that's the common track. There are different ways to come to this cross. There are different tracks and journeys that people make. And I think that's true. I think that when we think about the Bible verse of John 3:16, I often think, what is the most important word in that whole verse? For me, the most important and central word is whosoever, so that whosoever may believe would never perish, but would have eternal life. They believe in what that cross and the Jesus who died on it, what that means and represents. The whosoever come according to different paths and different ways and different journeys to come into the knowledge of Christ's salvation. I say thank God for that. Wouldn't it be so awfully boring if we all took the same journey, if it was familiar to every single person of what it means to come to the cross of Christ? I thank God that we can all uniquely come in our own way, whosoever we are, not mattering what country, what culture, what our history, what our baggage is. We can take different journeys to come to this central place of grace and love personified. We can all come our own way when we believe in Jesus, the whosoever, which is all of us coming to the cross of Christ to be saved. I love that about this painting, because I see all those different journeys and I see all the different stories that are contained within the many journeys that ultimately bring us to this common place at the foot of the cross. And that is so true. I think of people who have had come to Jesus moments in life, many of them in their journey to the foot of the cross. It's been a journey since they were children. They might have grown up in the church like I did, grew up in the Salvation Army, only ever really knew the Salvation Army from the youngest of ages, didn't know any other reality. Being at church all the time, always hearing on a weekly basis the name of Jesus spoken, always listening and learning about this journey, this way of following Jesus from a young age, and then making firm, solid decisions to follow Jesus, to take my journey, my particular way. But that's one way. There are others who come to Jesus in completely different ways. You think of that thief on the cross who hung there next to Jesus. He didn't grow up in church. He didn't get down on his knees and pray the sinner's prayer. He didn't have time to go to Bible studies. He didn't have time to consider the theology of what he was getting himself into. Whilst he was in the most vulnerable situation of his life, in his most desperate hour of need, he cried out to the Son of God who was dying at his side and simply asked Jesus to remember him. And Jesus said, "You will be with me in paradise. You will take your journey as others have done in different ways, but you in your way, in this most immediate hour, will come and take your journey and be with me." We don't all come to Jesus in an understanding of following Jesus and our understanding of salvation and our understanding of the theology even of the cross and what that means. We don't all come at that in the same way. We come at those things in different ways, according to who we are, according to our stories, according to how God calls us to follow him. I love that this particular painting seems to me to represent the individual journeys that are available, that many take, that are different diverse, have different curves, different shapes, come from different angles and directions, and yet they lead ultimately to the same source, Christ on the cross. I thank God for this painting, the inspiration behind it from Aunty Glenny. I thank God that in the simplicity of faith, when you think about what faith is contained within that most iconic verse from John 3:16, I thank God that the simplicity of that is also conveyed in a simple way in some ways, but also in a profound way through this particular representation of God so loving the world. It's a magnificent piece. It's worthy of sitting in a place of prominence within any house or any place of worship. It certainly gives honor to the artist who created it, but importantly, gives honor to our God and the magnificent rescue plan that he enacted that finds its center and its heart in the very cross of Christ. The sacrifice, the love, the grace that pours out of that cross and flows down in streams of living water to those who would drink deeply of Christ and his salvation and the freedom and the fullness that comes in living with Jesus when we follow him all the way. So loved by Aunty Glenny Naden, a magnificent piece that we reflect on today, and also doing so, we honour First Nations leaders, custodians, by considering the importance of their contribution to our nation here in Australia, but also to the church here in Australia. When we see pieces of art like this that are inspired by the same Dreamtime Spirit of God that created and shaped this ancient land that we live in here in Australia, when we consider this art and the inspiration behind it, we also honour those of the oldest civilization on planet Earth who have had a special place of connection with the God of the Dreamtime, the God whose very heart emanates pure love and light, the God at whose heart is the sacrificial love of Jesus and the cross. So loved by Aunty Glenny Naden, I give thanks to God for this piece of art, and I ask that this week you reflect on it. Allow it to continue to speak to you of God's love that would save anyone, the whosoever, including you, that you're a part of this art piece, that you're a part of this picture, that you come under the salvation of Jesus Christ. What a joy. What a place of absolute joy and love and knowing that we live under grace and that we are saved in and through Jesus. Let's pray. We thank you, God, because it is in the most simple yet profound way that we consider your love, your unconditional love, that would send Jesus into this world, this broken world, and we know how broken this world is and still is, that Jesus came to show us life in all of its fullness, but would also show us the meaning of love, would show us grace, would show us through his death on the cross that we can be saved. And we thank you for what that cross means for us. But yet we also thank you for the life that comes out of that sacrificial death, the victory of eternal life. We thank you for the events that will soon be upon us in this Lenten season. Lord, continue to speak to us as you draw us closer to Jerusalem, to that Holy Passion Week, as we consider in more depth what this cross means for our lives, but also what that empty tomb means for our lives. Bless us as we, the whosoever, continue to journey with you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. I thought it would be appropriate that the benediction that is left with us this day is a blessing that's prayed by a wonderful First Nations man. I've used this benediction blessing here in our online services before. So we're going to enjoy being blessed by Uncle Vince Ross, a wonderful, proud First Nations man here in the Salvation Army in Australia, who continues to do great work in his own journey with Jesus, but also a journey of reconciling First Nations people to other Australians. It's a wonderful blessing that he leaves with us today from Uncle Vince Ross, and you will hear that in a moment. But just before that, I'm going to say my farewells. We're going to head off for today, and I pray that this week for you is a wonderful week. We're going to be back here, of course, next Sunday, where we're going to be acknowledging International Women's Day, and we're going to be looking at an artwork which appropriately focuses on one woman in a very precious act. We look next Sunday at a wonderful piece of art by Simon Dewey entitled For She Loved Much. We'll look at that next Sunday, of course. Until then, God bless you. Uncle Vince Ross, pray your prayer of blessing over us in the only way you can, drawing upon the deep wisdom and roots of our ancient Great South Land of Australia. Bye for now.
May the God of creation warm your heart like the campfires of old. Bring wisdom and peace as shown to the first peoples of this land. Shake off the dust from the desert plains by the refreshing rains, followed by the glow and the warmth of the sun. And let the light of God show us the right path to take, and stand tall like the big river gums, drawing life from the ever-flowing waters. Amen.